There are several ways to add forms to the content of your website, both of them super easy and straightforward, of course. My name is Sophie, and in this video, I will show you how to add forms to a rich text editor and to a grid editor. Let's get to it. I've cheated a little and created a document type for us, where I've added two options. The first option is a rich text editor up here, and the second is a grid editor down here. One thing to note here is that when you want to add a form through the rich text editor, you need to make sure that the macro option is enabled. All right, so let's head over to the content section, where I've also already prepared a content node for us. So adding the form to the rich text editor is super easy. Simply click on the macro in the toolbar, choose insert form with theme. Under choose form, we'll go ahead and choose our first form. Since Umbraco Forms version 6, it's possible to create themes for your forms. Let's have a look at our options here. I've installed the starter kit on this side, which ships with a theme. That's the one that we can see here. But for the purpose of this video, I'm not going to choose any themes. When you do not pick a theme, Umbraco Forms will simply fall back to use the default theme that Umbraco Forms ships with. Great. Final thing we need to do here is exclude scripts, as we've chosen to load in the scripts at the bottom of our template. If you are loading your scripts inside the head tag on your template, you do not need to exclude scripts. All right, we'll hit submit. Now, if we give it a few seconds, we should see that our form is rendered here in the rich text editor. Voila! And that's one of the ways to add your forms to the content. Now let's go ahead and save and publish. And have a look at the front end. There it is, beautifully rendered. All right, the other way to add your form to the front end is through the grid editor. So let's head back over to the back office. We will just remove the form from our rich text editor here and move over to the next tab where we have our grid editor. Great, we'll start by adding a row and then we'll add content. Here we can choose to use either form or macro. For this video, we'll go with form. This will basically give us the same macro as the one we used in the rich text editor before. So we will choose our form here again. And again, I'm going with no theme. We're going to exclude scripts and submit. And again, we should see that our form will be rendered here in the grid editor. Great. Let's save and publish and have another look at the front end. There you have it. That's how easy it is to add your forms to your website. And that was also it for this video. In the next video, we'll talk more about how we can add more logic to our form by setting up conditions.